Test 1, 2, 3. Test 1, 2, 3. If you're in the chat room and can hear me and see me, let me know. Test 1, 2, 3. All right. Got a thumbs up there. All right. Awesome. Let's see. I got to bring some people in here. Y'all bear with me. We'll get started here. I think we got about 10 minutes. I'm getting everybody in.
Bingo.
Hey.
Hey.
Checking your mic levels. Michael, what's been going on?
Oh, son, it's pouring down rain right now. It's going to rain for about 2 more days.
Well, that stops fires.
So, yeah, you're right about that. It will stop them down here, I promise you. I'm thinking about going out this week, probably Wednesday or Thursday, if it'll ever quit raining.
Well, hopefully.
I'm hopefully off of a week.
Let's see.
Santa Claus good to you?
Oh, yeah, always. Always. Let's see. We got questions. We'll get those tonight. If y'all are just now joining us, I know we've got about 20 people in here. If you're wondering what we're doing, we're just getting set up and testing audio. We'll start at 9 and get going. I've got to find some software here real quick. Michael, I hadn't even had a chance to open that video yet. I've got it out on my desk here, but I don't, haven't done anything with it.
That's the only thing I was concerned about. I didn't know if that'd be enough.
Well, I'll holler at you. I'll get to it this week.
Okay.
I'm playing, unbelievable, dad again.
Yay. What do you do? Another child?
Well, one of my kids, you know, going through personal crap, and so end up with their kids for the last 3 weeks. And looks like after we talk tonight to her, probably have them another 3 weeks, which makes for sleepless nights or interrupted sleep nights.
You ain't getting no younger.
No. My hair hadn't fell out. It would have again, you know, the last 3 weeks. It's been rough. I'm trying to find the software. Oh, here it comes. Maybe. My computer is giving me heck tonight. I got one monitor. I got double monitors, you know, dual monitors. One of the monitors, there's Jason, that one of the monitors won't even come on.
Corey said he should be joining us, but he'll be late.
Oh, awesome. Let's see. Why is this just...
Hey, it's a formal occasion. Michael's got his shirt on.
Oh, yeah.
I like that. That's my new logo.
I told him it was a special night. He had to wear a shirt.
See my new logo?
Oh, yeah. I like that. Heck, yeah. I like it on your trailer and everything. It's just sexy. That's a good-looking logo. Good grief.
Oh, shit.
I got my glasses on. I can see Jason.
Okay, here we go. I think, let me see if we got sound on this. Oh, yeah, we got sound on that, so that's going to work tonight. That's good news. Apparently, I pulled it up twice. Don't know what for, why. Okay. Maybe that's why it was glitching. We should have Matt on here tonight. And As soon as I see Corey come in, I'll pull him in. And for those that are listening in right now, you're welcome to use the question section for questions. Okay. And some of those may get answered. Just, you know, one of us will type in an answer. You can use the chat room to chat with everybody. Too much audio, it says. You're breaking up, Ben. Have no idea why. Test 1, 2. Yeah, my audio is a tad high. Oh, yeah. Grandkids. How's the audio sound now on my end? A little better?
That was, works.
It was maxed out.
They press all buttons.
Freaking crazy.
You let your grandkids in your office?
No, but one got in here. I ran to the restroom. This is about 3 days ago. Didn't shut the door all the way. Well, I shut the door, didn't lock it. And ran to the restroom, come back, and he's in here, a 3-year-old. And he's got the cap off every marker I've got. He's got wires pulled. He's got everything. Well, I didn't notice that he had messed with my soundboard. And apparently it's been finagled with.
What does a $27 a month fee cover? Are all of your new articles have a separate cost? What are they actually getting for $27 a month? Seems like everything there is old news. On the platform to advertise your selling items for one that have been there for a few years, seems like it would be better off just starting purchase a new course.
Yeah, I see. Yeah, I replied to him. That's Jimmy Hardy. Jimmy apparently didn't watch the video or read any of the emails I sent him. And it gives a whole freaking laundry list of stuff that it gives you in the members area. Plus, we're constantly adding new stuff all the time. I think weekly we've been adding stuff. We just added a new course just for members, free. So I don't know what he means by all your new articles have a separate cost. It's not. So I don't know what it is. But I did answer him there. I replied to him. Hey, Happy New Year, Jose. I think you replied. I saw something from you on YouTube. Maybe YouTube. And then you gave me a 3-star rating on Facebook. Give me a 3-star rating on Facebook. On December 26th, somebody sent that to me today. A screenshot of it. And I was like, what in the heck? And it, I didn't get that. Oh, I know what it was. Jose put, where's the proof of all these vendors doing good in the business? Basically, you can talk all the stuff about, you know, basically, I don't believe what you're saying. Where are all these vendors that are making money? And yet we've been doing a show for 8 years, and we used to do it for the first 3 years every week. And we've had hundreds and hundreds of vendors on here, and we've had thousands of vendors guest post on the blog, and we've got thousands of vendors on Facebook. So I don't know what Jose needs exactly, like, because I can't get vendors to give me their, you know, their, what is it? W-2s from their, yeah. I doubt any of them will, but I do get fortunate. You know, I got Michael Wood here. I got Jason Brown here. Matt's here. And they do, they, you know, they, y'all are witness to the product. Matt's supporting his family. Jason's supporting his family. Michael is just part-time. He's been part-time for about 6 years now.
Yeah.
You know, they just gave me that brand new trailer free. When I went to pick it up, though, I had to give them, you know, a whole bunch of cash for it. But, I mean, you know, there's no money in this. I think I gave $3,500
right. For the trailer.
You know, that's not counting the rebranding that I just went through. When I ordered the T-shirts, they asked me for a check and a credit card number. And it just shocked me. I was
all right,
shocked.
Here we go. We're gonna go ahead and start this up.
Yeah. It's that time again, folks. Broadcasting live with his tin cans and a brand new string from atop Old Smoky. It's Ben, the King of Wiener Slingers, with a fancy co-host, with important guests, and the best answers a third grade education can buy. All for you. Sponsored by BensCarts.com, whiskey by the jug and donuts. You are so in for a treat today. But if I told you now, I'd have to kill you. Ben's as nervous as a long-tailed cat in a room full of rocking chairs. Stand by. He's downing his last glass of liquid courage, and he'll be live in 30 seconds.
Have you ever wondered why the guy selling hot dogs always seems so happy?
Hello, Mrs. Smith. Hello, Mr. Johnson. Can I interest either of you in a hot dog? Do you want to find out why?
Learn hotdogs.com. Get free video training. Earn points and get free stuff. Read Ben's hot dog blog and more. The premier source for hot dog vending information. Go to learnhotdogs.com.
All right, I do want to say Happy New Year to everybody. This is exciting to me. Jose, I wasn't picking on you. You know what I love about you and anybody like you is that you're skeptical. And I believe you should be. My tag on my truck says skeptic. I've got about six posters in my office all about being skeptic. I am a skeptic and a half. You can ask Jason. Jason probably knows more about that than anybody. Oh, yeah. I'm almost a skeptic to the asshole point. So don't think that I'm being hard on you or mean to you. I just wanted you to know that if you looked around, I'd appreciate, you know, the fact that you said that it was a typo and you'll change it. But it's you being skeptical. Don't change that. Always question. There is BS. There's lots of BS in marketing and business, and I could quit right now, not do any more shows. My income is not going to change. Jason could not come on here. His income isn't going to change. Neither will Michael's. Neither will Matt's. Our incomes won't change.
Change.
What?
My sleep would change.
Right. You'd get a little more sleep on Sunday nights once a month, right? I'm with you. And then there's preparation that goes into this. Me and Jason were talking 3 hours ago about this show, working out what we're going to discuss and how to do it and this and that. And even though I know we're not professionals, we don't have, you know, all these cool graphics and cool stuff going on. My point is that we volunteer this time and donate this time to help everyone. And it also helps us. So it's not like it's not mutually rewarding. There's stuff that Matt has brought up that we didn't know. There's stuff that Jason brings up constantly that we didn't know. Michael's same way. Michael's like one of these, you know, like some kind of algorithm way out in left field where he can create money in Podunkville and gets, I mean, you have stuff booked, Michael, right? All the way till November, all the way till November next year. And he's part-time. Okay. So I knew it was September or November. I wasn't sure.
Well, what happens is usually when I do an event, whether it's a catering or whether it's a festival or whatever it is, 99% of the time I'm told, come back next year, same time, and we're going to do the same thing again. So I automatically book them, and I've had to turn down a whole lot, you know, because I work full time, so I don't have time to do everything. And I turned down a few events this year or last year that I didn't really want to turn down, but I did. And I still did 9% better than any other year I've ever had. I had my highest year this year in 2016. And, you know, but I only do this part-time, and the big checks that Ben sends me, I mean, I don't know what I'd do with all that extra money.
And you donated a buttload of money to charity this year.
It's about $1,100,
$1,200
right now.
Freaking awesome.
Which ain't a whole lot of money, but to me.
I don't know. I'll bend over and pick up a $10 bill in a heartbeat on the sidewalk. Hell, I'm one of these people that picks up pennies. I can be walking through a Walmart parking lot and I'll pick up a penny. Hey, let me do this real quick and we'll get started. Jose, I wasn't picking on you. Just know that you're welcome here. I hope you get value out of it. I hope you remain skeptical. But I want you to know the information is here. It's on the blog. Where you can talk to, people on our Facebook page. I think there's a little over 16,000 vendors there. And you can talk to these people. And some of them may not connect with you. Some of them may ignore you and go, I don't want to talk to him. But some of them will. And then you'll know. Then you'll know this is a valued asset. It is something that's doable. It's not something that's a pie in the sky that's hidden, you know, one in a million.
I mean, it's pretty simple. I mean, you and I are both reachable. I mean, you know, emails on the bottom of my phone, let me see, 3,000, whatever it is there. Can you see it?
Yeah, I see that. That sucks.
So, you know, I can't tell you how many of those are actually from the show.
I would go in there and just delete. If I had that many emails right now, I'd hit delete this app. And it would
open 3,546. I've been answering emails all day.
And you know, I'm the same way, but I get stressed out if I get 100 of them behind. And the other day, Heather's telling people that I'm, you know, 3 days behind on emails. Please send him the ask, you know, go to learnhotdogs.com/askben. Well, then it's instant.
To be fair, only 1,145 are show related.
Holy cow. Yeehaw. Hey, I want to go through and introduce everybody real quick. Happy New Year to everybody. This is the first show of the year and we're talking about doing some changes. I may wait till next month to tell you about those changes with the show itself. If you're a Street Food Pro member, you'll know first, cause you'll be told first. And you may be told this week, but there's some changes coming. There's some other stuff though we're going to cover tonight. Jason's got some stuff and, I want to introduce real quick, everybody, and give us a catch up. What's your plans for this coming year? Not New Year's resolutions. I don't give a crap about resolutions. I'm talking about just, you know, what's your plans? What's your goal? Where are you going to go with this? What are you going to do? What's your old goal? Let's start with you, Michael. Go ahead.
Well, my goal is to increase my sales. It seems like just about every year since I've been in business, I've been doing that. But the way my path for doing that is I rebranded, got a new logo, got a new trailer. Hopefully, I'll get a new hot dog cart this year. I'm not sure. I've got a particular design that I want, and that's still in my head. But I'm going to go more for catering than anything because I make more money doing catering and it takes less time. But my spouse, I enjoy doing those because it's fun. And I'm still going to – I'll probably limit it to about the same, maybe 70.
What is that noise? What is the water noise?
We're getting a lot of feedback, like somebody's doing dishes or something.
That's not me.
Yeah, I can't tell where.
But
it doesn't show me.
I do not plan to go out any more than I did last year. So that's pretty much the whole big plan. I'm kind of lazy, I guess I should say, but it makes it a lot more better for me. And it should be in August. I should get laid off from my real job, and then I'll be officially retired. And that's, you know, pretty much
all right. About it. Well, that is still good. You've made a lot of progress. I know this year you had some this past year you had some major changes. Just to let everybody know real quick, as we go through these intros, if you have a question, put it in the question tab, because that's the only thing I have up. I don't have the chat room up. Some of y'all.
Can I ask Matt a question?
Yeah. Matt, yeah.
How are you cooking the grilled cheese sandwiches? Do you have a flat?
No, I have two steam irons.
Yeah, have you seen The Walking Dead, and you've seen Negan with the fire, you know, the iron in the fire? That's how we kind of steam them down. Now, I have a flat top. I think I posted a couple pictures in the group and Street Food Pros.
He's got a Peter Pro with the griddle.
Yeah. So.
Okay. Well, see, I've got a redneck griddle, and it fits on the top of my grill. I've done grilled cheeses before, and I may go back to them. I was just curious.
No, it's freaking awesome. I love those pictures Matt posted up the other day in our group on Facebook page, the Vendors United group. Holy cow. delicious-looking freaking grilled cheeses. Matt, why don't you go next? Go ahead and spill the beans. What's your plans this year?
Well, the plans is we're going to be, over the next week, we're going to be doing a name change, actually, from the traditional bow ties and hot dogs to the bow tie food cart, just reflecting the change in menus we've got. We'll still, of course, be serving hot dogs and everything, but we're either going to do food cart or lunch cart, not sure. And then once we get the logo change, we'll do that. But pretty simple change on that, just to reflect the catering, the different menus we're doing, salads and pastas and grilled cheeses and soups and tacos and everything we're doing now. So that's the big plan this year, is really just to kind of expand the menu and you know, go from there, try to go indoors or something at some point, maybe in 2018. So that'll probably be the working plan for this year.
That's exciting. I like the fact that you're going to change it. You know, I started out as Hillbilly Hot Dogs, and then I changed it to Hillbilly Catering and Hot Dogs, and probably should go to Hillbilly Catering and Food Services or something. But I like hot dogs. Hillbilly Hot Dogs just sounds good to me. But Jason, go ahead. Give us some updates and give us a teaser.
Oh, boy. Let's see. Ski resorts in full swing, and getting ready to go back to the corporate gigs starting next Tuesday, and the college that following weekend. So 5 days of corporates, 7 days of ski resort, and 2 to 3 days of college. So keeping us busy, just a lot more catering. We started a microgreens company, so we're growing microgreens to sell to restaurants now, so we got that going on, and that's taking off pretty quick. Are we going to tease them about?
Yeah, go ahead.
All right, some of the upcoming things, we'll be doing some licensing deals. So if you guys want to hit us up on email, we're going to be licensing out Love Food Truck, Love Hot Dog Company, Sugar Skulls Barbecue, Lemonade Brothers. We had a few spots for every, you know, for a few people. We're not going to take on a whole lot. We're going to be working one-on-one with Ben and I. So shoot us an email if you're interested, and we'll see if you're a good fit, and we'll let you know. So yep, that's probably one of the biggest things for the new year.
We'll probably talk more about that the first Sunday of February, but a huge deal. If you want to get started or rebrand with the Love Food Truck or Love Hot Dogs or Lemonade Brothers or any of those, there's going to be an opportunity for you where you get a ton of support and you get a some other valuable assets that I can't go into yet because freaking attorneys. So there's the teaser. Then we also have some other new stuff coming where you can train with vendors. We've already have it in effect. There's several vendors you can train with right now. If you're new and listening to this and want to go visit a vendor, we have a system set up where you can go visit with a vendor, a pro vendor, and do that. I also want to mention that Heather is in the background here. Not really in the background. She's in the foreground, but she's not on screen. She's actually, you see that green thing behind me? She's back there. I got her in the corner.
Gets her in a cage.
Yeah, she's actually in Oregon. But she's helping. Heather does all the back end stuff with Facebook. She does everything on the blog. If I write a new article, she puts it up. She corrects my spelling. As y'all know, I didn't finish the third grade. And she helps with the street food pro team, the Vendors United group. If you're not a part of that, you need to look at that. Heather may put up the link in the chat room and you can check that out. I think she has a link where you can try it out for like 5 days free. I know that, even though what's his name said that he didn't know what the value was. There actually is a value. Oh, it was Jimmy Hardy. Happy New Year. I know people are posting Happy New Year. I appreciate that. Here's another one. Jose says, plan is to purchase a cart. Financing didn't work, so I'm waiting in income tax to buy a cart. Ben, I'm a little skeptical, yes, but that's normal. But I do enjoy your show. Learned a lot through your book and videos. We'll buy a cart, hopefully, from you soon. I'm also a trained chef. You know what? We've had some awesome freaking trained chefs. We've had them on the show. That one, what's his name from Canada? Alberta, Canada. Holy cow. He has grown and grown and grown. And now he turned his cart. He did like Corey and went and has a restaurant now and a food cart, but his food cart is still kicking butt even through the winter. Hopefully, see you soon. Let's see, been a chef 25 years and I can be of help. Recipes or ideas, I'm open. Absolutely. Especially if you're a member of the Vendors United group, we'd love you to share some recipes. Jason has shared a blue million of them. Matt has shared them. There's a lot. Corey shared them. And so those are always positive benefits. They help each other and we can create new things. It doesn't hurt competition because we're not typically in the same town or even in the same block. I wanted to talk real quick about some of the stuff that we have. What I would tell you to do as you think about starting a business, or you want to expand, or you want to grow it. Maybe you're joining the show and you're going, oh my gosh, I've never, considered the business. And I know we have a lot of people tonight watching football games. I bet I got over 100 email responses tonight. When it sends out those things about the show, when people hit reply, it goes directly to me. I got to change that. But they hit reply, it goes to me. Ben, I can't make it. Got a show. Going to be at the bar. Going to be here. You know, my neighbor's chicken's having puppies. Can't make it. Whatever it is. I don't care. And this is always available free later. You can come back and watch it later. So you don't have to be here. But for the people that do listen to this, if you're starting out, do your due diligence. This is the biggest mistake vendors make in the beginning because we get all excited. There was so many times when I started out, I could have failed and failed abruptly to the point I couldn't have moved on had just the luck went a different way. This business isn't about luck, but if you try to wing-ding this and try to just, fly by the seat of your pants type deal, you'll find quickly that there's things you'll mess up on. No matter how brilliant you are, you'll mess up. Jason's messed up. I've messed up. Michael's messed up. Matt's messed up. Corey, John, all of us have messed up. But the key is the reason that those mess ups didn't stop us from keeping going and making good money was doing our due diligence. And some of it will bore you to tears. Some of it you don't even want to know about. You don't want to deal with. Like, I hate taxes and bookkeeping. Hate it with a freaking passion. Okay. So I have somebody doing it for me. When I had my first cart, I was paying $30 a month for a lady to go through my little yellow pad sheet and convert that over to QuickBooks so that at the end of the year, I could give it to an accountant who I paid only $200 at the time. So if there's things you just can't deal with, there's solutions around it. And we have already talked about those solutions. We have the solutions for you. You know, I had a guy call me this week, Jason, you'll love this one. Called me this week and said, Ben, I know the sales line, blah, 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 but I got a real important question. I can't find it on your site anywhere. Do you know a good insurance company? And I about fell out of my freaking chair. Now listen, I don't make anything off the insurance company. You're welcome to go and look at the blog on the right-hand side of every page on the blog and every cart page on our normal website. There is an insurance link to a company called Flip, okay? And if you want to go through them, great. It'll save you money, period. It'll save you money and they're good. Jason's the one that introduced us to them 2.5-3 years ago, okay? And now they've even gone above and beyond and gave the Vendors United group a special discount. So if you're a Vendors United member, you get a better discount than anybody else in the world. In fact, you'll pay less for insurance than anyone else in the world under any insurance plan. So, yeah, you sent me an email about it, Michael.
Yeah, I just renewed it.
So it's not like you're going to save thousands because it ain't thousands. It ain't thousands. I was paying about $600 a year per cart with State Farm when I started, or Allstate. It was Allstate. I believe it was Allstate. I have to go back to my book. It's in my book. But that's what I'd recommended, $50 a month, you know, per cart. And then this is $299. And then Vendors United members get a special discount off that. So $299.
You get 10,000 in the marine policy free.
Yeah, you get that free. Plus, you get the additional $1 million benefit, which no other insurance company I know of does that. Now, there could be, but they're going to charge you more for it. So that was just off the side there. Somebody called me about that and said, I've looked everywhere and do you recommend a certain insurance company? I was like, are you freaking kidding me? And I know it's hard to find everything on the site, but do your due diligence. If you'll notice it at hotdogcartstore.com and learnhotdogs.com at the very top of the page, you will see start here or free training. Click on either one of those, walk through it. I have the long version and the short version listed. So if you want a lot of information, bore you to tears information, go the long way. If you want the short version, I got like 8-minute videos, give you step by step by step what to do real quick. Don't explain nothing. Just say, do this, do this, do this, do this. So I got it both ways for you. And I want to see you succeed. Whether you buy a cart from me or not, or whether you join Vendors United, I don't give a rat's butt. I want to see you succeed. I've succeeded. Jason succeeded. Michael succeeded. Matt succeeded. Matt was working how many hours a week, Matt?
70 to 90.
with vending. You were working in food industry though.
Yeah, that was when I managed Cracker Barrel. I mean, I went from working, 70 to 90 to, now 30. I think so.
And are you making comparable incomes?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. I mean, I didn't kill it this year, but I definitely fed the family, took care of the bills and everything else, yeah, it's all about hard work and everything too. I mean, people that are skeptical, yeah, be skeptical because it's going to help you out. I'm sorry, my dog's going crazy in the background, but, not one to be quiet.
Freaking rednecks from Tennessee.
Yeah, well, he's 6 months old. That's that Doberman I came home with the one night. So yeah.
I saw you post that.
Oh yeah, that was our end of the year picture. I put him up in a bow tie and was like, "Oh, guys, have a great year." But usually he's pretty good, but he doesn't want to be out there. It's been a great year, but it's all about hard work. You can, Junior's just talking about the profit margin, yes, carts make more money than trailers for profit margin. Well, at least straight off the bat, there are advantages to trailers and such like that, but you can get into a cart much cheaper and such, but,
you can be in the black quicker.
Yeah. I mean, it's just, there are advantages to trucks. Obviously there are advantages to trailers. you know, especially 3 hours I spent out Friday were in 34 degrees. So, you know, but it sold a lot of soup and grilled cheese, you know, so there's a lot of advantages to it. Man, I forgot the original question, though.
No, I was just, I was saying that you used to work your butt off. I was just going on a tangent about the hours you put in, and by doing your due diligence, you've been successful this year working a third of the hours you were working at Cracker Barrel.
Oh yeah. And that's been the best part of it. It's just the comparative, you know, I did 12 years in restaurant management and killing myself building something for someone else. You know, spending my entire 20s, you know, building something for other people and corporations. And now it's just everything I do is built for me and my family. So, you know, that's the best part of it is every minute I put into it is a return for me personally and for my family, not somebody else.
There is a, hold on just a second. Somebody asked a question. Somebody else talk about something while I look up an answer for a feller on a portable fridge, mobile fridge. I have one. Nobody going to talk?
I'll talk. Hey, Matt, pull your mic a little closer for me.
I'm trying to keep the gain down.
You're really soft.
How's that?
That's better.
All right.
Thank you.
I know we wanted to talk about the crock pot cooking tonight.
Yeah, look.
I've got them over here. I was going to bring them over here to show kind of what I did the past couple of weeks. I'd messaged Ben because I saw on Facebook, you know, crock pot cooking. And one of the big things I talked about was I had just done it the week before. And I know Ben's always talked about starting without a cart. And that, to me, is one of the easiest ways to do it is, it was getting real cold and some of the customers are older, didn't want to come out, you know, that worked at the call centers and such. So they said, why don't you come inside? And so I said, well, you know, I can do that. No problem. So let me go grab it. I'm going to just step right over here and grab this. So I'm going to do soup one day. So what I did, I got a standard griddle. You can do this with hot dogs too. Yeah, same thing as a steam pan. I don't know if you guys can see here. Let me see. Pick this up for $29.99. It's a triple crock pot. I think it's 1.5 quarts or two in each one of them. So, I mean, you're talking regular size hot dogs. You could easily fit, I don't know, 10 to 15. Hey, come here, Onyx. This is the best hot dog slinger in the world. He's appearing here. Say hey, buddy. Hey. Say hey, guys.
Hey.
Onyx. He's my buddy. That's Jason. He's waving at you. See, he's in Pennsylvania.
Hey, pal.
but we went out and we did. I put three different soups. I did the griddles for grilled cheese, and they came to me inside. So no cart. Talking about setup was easy. And you went there with hot soup, turned it on, bang, 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 kept it warm for a couple hours. You know, I refilled it, had containers, everything. But super easy. So you're talking, you know.
Try making grilled cheese croutons for your soup.
I did that the other day. I took the leftover mixture. The people that showed it, what I do a three cheese grilled cheese. And the third cheese is a Parmesan butter mixture, garlic mixture. Well, I took the remaining of that mixture, added some more liquid margarine and olive oil, and made took the crust of the bread and made croutons. And they weren't ready for Friday, but my wife and kids ended up eating them at home. So, but we used to do that at one of the restaurants I worked. We made our own croutons and everything, but we just did the crust. But that's a great way. If you don't have one of these, I got a roaster. You cook a turkey in. There's three pan dividers in them. You can use one of those. You can use a panini press, you know, a George Foreman grill. electrical outlets, just make sure you clean up, be respectful. You're inside their building. It's a little different, you know. But most of them love it, especially when it's 30 degrees out. They don't want to come outside and stand around.
Right.
I mean, a lot of these places have really great lunch rooms they can let you in. I know this place, I had two or three tables they let me set up on, and, you know, we had a great old time. So I'd highly recommend that. That's something else you can do. It's one more advantage to going private, going commercial. You're inside, you know. You do limit your business. You're not going to get walk-in business, you know. That's the only thing. You're going to only get the business there. But if you've got a call center with 300, 400 people, and you can even pull 50 to 75 of those people, shoot, say you're charging $8, $9 a person, even if you can pull 30 and you're only there an hour and a half, 2 hours, you still had a pretty good day. Man, if you do soup, I just tell you, the profit margins of soup are ridiculous. I mean, they make hot dogs look just stupid. I mean, you make your own chicken.
Everything you do off of the three crock pots there would be, you know, burritos. If you got a small flat top electric grill, you can heat up a 10, 12-inch burrito shell. I mean, throw down cheese, keep rice and black bean in one, two different kinds of meat, and then on the side, you got your guac in a squirt bottle, you know, salsa, ladle that on and roll it, you know. We sell the hell out of burritos. The ski resort, we put out a burrito that's a pound. We charge $10 for it.
Well, I do Taco Tuesday every Tuesday. And, yeah, I haven't done that inside this, but you could very easily do the rice, the beans in here. You could even put the meats in here with enough broth to make sure it stays warm. Put it on the little grill, the griddle. You're done. You know, all winter you're staying warm. I mean, you could do it in the summer like that if you wanted to. It's a great way to do it without a cart, you know. We're not talking hot dogs here necessarily. It can be modified and changed to anything. You know, I like I said, I picked this up from Aldi for $29.99 because I wanted a bigger one. I know Walmart's clearancing these right now because they had them for Christmas and such like that.
So, Onyx. You have some stuff booked ahead now, Matt, with indoor stuff that you're going to be using that method?
Yeah, I'll be back out Thursday with this. I'll be doing it inside at my Whirlpool location here in Knoxville. Probably be doing pretty much if it's below 50 degrees with Whirlpool, I'm going to be inside. Now, like I do a bank call center, and I can't go inside there for obvious reasons. They have security. Like, I can't even go use the bathroom there. So they're pretty much a lockdown if you don't have a badge, and they're really nice, but you can't go inside. So there are some locations you're not going to be able to do that, but factories, other things like that, I know you can get inside doing that. Regal, a big entertainment group I do, I can go inside there. You know, and there are some nice things. If I don't have to go inside, I don't want to, because I like using my cart. It's quicker. It is quicker. I mean, you are dealing with less powerful equipment. I mean, I can obviously, on my burners on my Cater Pro, I can heat up stuff and cook stuff faster on my gas griddle and my gas steam line than on this. You know, when I use this, I try to make sure the stuff is hot ahead of time. You know, whereas with the cart, I can take cold product and add as I need to. Because this is obviously, while it's good for what it is, you know, it is a slow cooker. It's a crock pot. It's supposed to cook something over 3 or 4 hours. So it can easily keep stuff warm and to temperature. But if you want to cook something and bring it up from 30, you know, 38 degrees to 165, it's going to take a while. So there's the other hot dog sermon. Hey, say hey, guys.
Hey.
That's the original guy right here. This is Jet, but he's always in school. So, but he does all my money and everything. Whenever he's been great being home from school with the vacation, because now I've got a cashier every single day. If Blair doesn't want to go out or anything, he does all my money for me.
That is so cool. Because
child labor is the best thing in the world.
It's incredible. Hey,
Matt, yeah.
I've done some events kind of like what you're doing now. And what I did is on one, it was an auction. And what I did is I set the hot dog cart up outside because they didn't want smoke inside. And I cooked the food outside, brought it in, and served it inside. And I was able to cook a lot more food quicker. And, well, I had help also. But I was able to shuttle food back and forth, and it made it where I could cook anything I wanted to.
And Tennessee's, the fire marshal will let us here take a cart indoors as long as it has the 1 pound.
1 pound, yeah. And that's how the coffee guy gets away. He goes in the local coffee cart. Mm-hmm. He gets away because he's a 1 pound propane tank. But I have done that with I do a monthly catering with a doctor's office here, a dentist office, actually. And we do something similar like that because we'll do fajitas. We'll do something different every month. And I'll cook outside, and Blair will kind of help with the service inside. I've done that with birthday parties. I'll kind of be outside, and Blair will manage the party inside, manage the buffet line, the service. And she'll just kind of keep me, you know, hey, we need another baked bean. I'll get another pan of baked beans going. Hey, you need another mac and cheese. You know, I'll warm up another mac and cheese. You know, and that's catering on the cart where it's at its best. You know, if you're doing a 70, 80 person catering birthday party and you can just keep cooking the stuff you need to, you know, it really helps, you know, to have that full cart. But there's options, you know, and to whoever was, you know, asking, you know, is this real? That's real. You know, literally, I saw Ben's thing about the crock pot and it's like, dude, I just did this last week. And it's great. Because it lets you get out of the cold. I mean, I think I dodged a 28 degree day the other day because of this, you know, standing outside. Whoever's got that ringer, I wish I had it because I want an old ringer like that.
No, I am getting a call from Retro Vending and don't know what that is or why it's there, how it came there. I don't even know where it's coming from.
Well, it's coming from Florida.
Yeah, but I don't know if it's part of the app here. Is there a thing where you can call
there,
in?
There was.
I don't know. I know he's been having problems getting in. I know a lot of people have. I apologize, and that's, you know, if you just get your questions over on the side, we'll try to get them answered to tonight. But I guess if you can't hear that, doesn't help.
I can try answering it, but it keeps popping up.
Let's send him an answer on this question here.
Yeah, he said, any suggestions on a permanent location with my cart, one where I leave the cart there? How about stocking and resupply?
I mean, well, that's pretty easy. I mean, you know, stocking and resupply, that's why we have the box truck running out to different locations. You know, in the morning it runs out with coolers, ice packs, with, you know, frozen stuff and drops off. You got chips, soda, water, paper products, all that kind of stuff, produce.
I had a Datsun pickup that I did it with 22 carts I had running, and did it with a Datsun pickup.
You know, as far as location, I mean, you can go search location on the site. I mean, we've done shows on it. I mean, that one night, it was Corey and I think you were away or something. We did a show, 100 and some locations. We talked about it one night. You know, that's still there.
Yeah.
As Ben says, there's a blue million of them.
Some state health departments require you to return your cart back to your commissary each day. So you may want to look at that too.
Yeah, some states do want you to return it to your commissary. I mean, it's not like they follow you around, though. 99% of the time I took mine home and covered it up.
I'll tell you, here it's getting a little stricter. As a commissary owner, you now have to sign a paper stating that, like, Ben uses my commissary, disposes of gray water, fills fresh water, and parks here, and then I have to notarize it, hand it back into the health department.
They do that in South Carolina and North Carolina now.
They're doing spot checks now. They're coming out at night. So, you know, if the person's not doing what they're supposed to be doing, it can jam me up as a, you know, as a commissary owner. So, you know, it's made me have to change a few things here.
I'd rather spend my tax dollars following around politicians than following around a food truck that's trying to make a living.
Well, they make it nice and easy on the food. You know, it's easier to chase the food trucks than a politician, you know. Shit.
Oh. One other thing about those 1 pound gas canisters, I keep like three of them on my cart as a backup fuel in case I run out, because I only have two tanks on my big dog. But I had the gas company make me a valve that I can screw into the 1 pound cans, and also into the just the regular hookup on the big dog. So I don't, all I have to do, if I run out of gas, I just screw it in and I got gas.
And you can get a converter. And I remember, Michael, I don't remember what video it was or what episode you talked about that a long time ago. And even when I first started out, I went out and got a converter from, I think it was the Coleman outlet up in Pigeon Forge, and that could convert it and do that. And it saved me once before. Because you think you got, oh, I got enough gas today, and then, uh-oh. I bought all the U-Haul tanks that have the little gauge on them, but those aren't always accurate depending on temperature and such.
You mean the lie meter?
Yeah.
Yeah, I've tried those, and they ain't worth a flip, in my opinion.
No, they're not. I wouldn't recommend buying them after I've already purchased them now. They're not worth the $20. And then if you're in an emergency, too, you hate to trade them in. That's what I've found before. I didn't want to trade them in, you know, in an emergency at a gas station or something to get an extra tank. So I probably got a couple of propane tanks lying around now. But.
Minimum requirements for a commissary in Georgia. Can I rent a trailer that isn't used for living in for one?
I guess he's meaning like some RV or something.
Well, as long as it has the stuff, Georgia, I believe, is a four bay sink, a three bay sink, and a hand wash sink, a floor drain, and a cooler. I think they have to have, I think Georgia requires a mop sink, if I remember correctly, for a commissary, but they may not.
You got to have the thermostats on your refrigerators too.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, well, Tennessee allows you to put them inside. Mm-hmm. You know, the ones you just magnet to the side of the inside.
And you still have the electric cart, right? It's an option.
Yeah. I just emailed him. We've had the electric carts now for a little over 3 years. The cash cow comes that way, and the pro dog comes that way. And I believe the King Kiosk comes that way. It does.
And then Junior Land just asked, trailer versus car, what makes a better return or best return? It just depends on what you're doing and where you're working. Obviously, if you're somewhere you can run a car all year round, like Georgia, you know, versus here with snow on the ground, well, you know, obviously you might not be standing out in the cart during the winter up here, but you can be inside a trailer. So I guess it would depend, Junior, where you're at and what you're doing.
Yeah, you know? And honestly, the truth is we have vendors with carts in Canada and Alaska, but a trailer has other benefits, more food selection, but they have a negative to them because you have to, one, parking, you can't go as in as many places, but you also have more equipment to buy. You have to have an air handler. You have to have a fire suppression system in most states. Some states will let you get away with it if you can prove that you're not going to produce any vapor-laden...
grease-laden vapor.
Grease-laden vapors into the air. They'll let you not have the fire suppression, but they're still going to have you have an air handler and stuff like that. So I would look at all the things. I think Jason and I actually did a show on this particular subject. We did a whole show on it. You remember that? We did the pros and cons of a food truck versus a cart about a year and a half ago. It's on learnhotdogs.com. I know it's there.
Yeah, I'm trying to remember which one it was. It's before I.
Yeah.
It's... And the cart.
It's a mini fridge, right?
A hot dog cart would draw people also because people see it. Oh, I had one of those or seen one of those in New York when I was a kid. And I hear that every day.
Right.
But. It's some both will, you know. Trucks will too, you know, not putting the, because obviously, you know, I'm going to be probably end up being like Corey. I'm never going to get rid of my cart, but I would like a trailer as well or a truck, you know, for the menu expansion, everything else, you know, I'm kind of, you know, but comes down to affordability too. You know, like Ben said, you're going to be in the black a lot quicker with a cart, unless you just found a, unless you're very, very good at building it yourself. I mean, that is an option. You can build out a trailer yourself. You can build out a truck yourself. It's going to be a lot of work if you're handy. But you got to really know the details of your health codes, and not just health codes, fire codes, electrical codes. You know, it's a little more complicated, you know.
I've always said you're going to be a food trucker or a food truck builder. There's a lot of guys that start that project and get head over their head, can't get licensed. We've got all those guys calling to the show, and, you know, right. That's just a whole other bag of worms, man.
You're right. The I just gave him a link, and I'm going to give him another one. We've actually done two things on this. Let's see.
Man, if you're really wanting it, I mean, Ben just did something, and we haven't even mentioned it, but that new financing deal you had.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my goodness. Get a stand-in. Yeah. You know, do whatever you want. I mean, literally with a griddle and two steam pans, I can make about anything.
Anything.
I mean, yeah, I can do. I mean,
yeah.
And, you know, and with slight modification, or, you know, you can get Keith to modify a little bit, or even if you did it yourself, like somebody was asking about, can you get electrical on one? Yeah, Keith can probably get that done. Or any electrician in your local state would be able to wire that thing pretty easily for a generator. And then you can have electrical in it, whatever. But it's a great, you know, it's a lot bigger when you see one. I know I've been up to the shop and seen them. They're really cool. You know, they're big, you know, you're talking 6x10. That's a big space for two people. You know, you can have a two-person work crew out of that thing. And what are they running now? If you're a Mafia member, 10 grand or something like that?
Yeah, less than 10 grand, you can get one. And with the new payment, with that, I mean, we have the standard financing where you pay for it, you know, three times through that company, but it's still a pretty easy company to get approved through. The other one is a little stricter, but they break it up into 12 payments, roughly. It's 13 payments, and you have it done within 12 months. So divide whatever you want to buy by 12 and then make an extra payment. That is their fee. So if your payment's 300 a month, then the fee's 300. That's it. Instead of
That's less than 10% interest.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, better than a credit card.
I mean, you know,
when
you think about it that way, that's less than 10% interest. That's
yeah.
Yeah. I mean, that's a car loan. That's pretty darn good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's like 8% interest, on annual interest rate, not even a monthly, reoccurring.
Yeah. It's just flat. I mean, isn't it yeah. just,
I mean most credit flat. Cards are 1.5% a month. So you're at 18% a year. And so it's a great deal. There's also the, right now, and I'll be sending out an email about this more. I did a double your money thing, and it glitched. Some people weren't able to do it, and it ended at midnight. They left it up. It's on the blog at learnhotdogs.com. You can go over there right now and grab it. Go to learnhotdogs.com. It'll be the third post down the page, and you can double your money, which means if you basically you're getting a voucher for $100, and you get $200 to spend. Or you get a voucher for $500, you get $1,000 to spend. So, but it's a limited time, and it was supposed to end at midnight. And anyway, I got cussed out over this twice today, once by email, once by phone. But either way, I'm getting it fixed, and I will be announcing it again, but it's still available right now. You can still use it.
You could also get the cash cow. Or get to build a cart and do the same thing.
Exactly.
And not spend a lot of money. I mean, when I started with a big dog, but that's what I wanted.
I got a guy with four build a carts, Michael. Four. He's built four.
You know, and if you can do something like that, you know, build your own cart. And I mean, just as long as you do it to code.
Yeah, which isn't hard, and most codes are pretty easy as long as you have a food safe top, and you have the number of sinks they want, and the water reserve that they need, And that's pretty much it. And a cooler on board. And it can be electric or just a standard cooler as long as you can prove that it won't maintain a temperature. Well, even a Coleman cooler you go buy at the Coleman outlet or Walmart will maintain a temperature all day long below the freezing level or below 42 or whatever their requirement is. Some people use their coolers for hot stuff when they're doing catering gigs. I do. You know, the hot and cold coolers, hot or cold. Jason, you look like you were going to say something.
Yeah, I'm going to do the cooler for hot. I recommend boiling some water and putting it in there to hold for a little while before you drop your stuff in. It helps it stay longer.
Good idea. See, another tip, boiling water. I never knew that. Never did it.
Yeah, preloading it. You know, same thing with coal. We always ice our coolers before we use them. Nelson's in Ohio. I bought those gigantic freezer packs. They're 3 foot long, 2 foot tall. I have those for our coolers on really hot days. We line the back of that big igloo boat cooler with them, or the bottom, or we lay it across the top and stuff. So, you know, there's plenty of ways. I mean, God, we even did a show where, didn't you show how to make them or something? Or we did a couple of things on ice packs. Remember?
Oh yeah. We did a whole tip thing on how to create your own ice packs.
Yeah.
That were awesome. That will hold up better than water, you know, frozen water.
Yep.
I think that's called ice. I know there's some people having problems tonight. I apologize. I don't know what the issue is. Every time we have a show,
it's the Russians.
Every time we have a show, though, we have issues. But see, we've tried how many platforms? Maybe 5 or 6.
Yeah.
And I've never found one that was perfect for everybody.
Nope.
This
has been by far the best for a while.
Yeah, it's been the best. I know Michael had trouble with that last one we had. He had trouble with this one at first, but
that was a loose knot behind the wheel, though.
I don't think he's listening. I think
he's not listening.
I'm using my phone.
Oh.
Is why I'm not having trouble. I'm not using my computer.
Oh.
See, we have to have a little squirrel. He runs to town and writes down the note and then brings it back, and I have to read the note so I can hear what's, you know, going on.
Well,
it's a joke. You're supposed to laugh.
I hate
it
was a delay, Michael. It was just a time delay between the video. Don't worry.
Yeah.
Jason's about to laugh right now.
I hate that it's this way. But I know that people go back and listen to them. Last month was huge. Over 10,000 downloads we got last month of this show, just on iTunes.
Oh, it shows up, what, tomorrow on Martin Hot Dogs, right?
Yeah, it depends on me mostly. And right now I have a 3-year-old and a 1-year-old that I'm getting to watch.
Welcome to my world.
Dude, I already did it, though. I already put in I should have already been on parole by now. And then to have to re-up, it sucked, you know? Yeah, it's like, oh, me and my wife, literally, here's our plans. Let me tell you this real quick. My wife and I decided we decided this back in August. We're going to sell our house because it's a big house, okay? We don't need this much room anymore. We're down to our last child under 18. We're going, and he's homeschooled. We're going to travel, and I'm going to go from state to state and visit as many vendors as I can, and that's what I'm going to do. And I'm going to get a mobile home, a single wide, with only one bedroom so that nobody can come visit me, okay? No, not for a long time, right? I'm going to put a tent in the yard. You can come visit as long as you want to live in a tent. So my goal, this mostly applies to my kids. So this is what my goal was. I even told Jason, I got excited back in August. I got excited. I'm going to do this. And then this happened. And now my daughter is going to be moving in with me here in 3 more weeks after we've kept her kids 6 or 5, 6 and yeah, 6 and be here indefinitely. So that puts off that whole plan. And kind of just want, you ever felt like running away from home?
Oh, yeah.
I remember telling my dad that one time when I was about 12, or maybe I was less than that, but he grabbed me a sack and he goes, go get your clothes, boy. Head on.
I told mine he'd leave with everything he bought. He said, that's nothing. I said, exactly. So you'd be running out the door naked. Good luck.
Yeah. Have fun, buddy.
Don't let the door hit you or the good Lord splits you.
How many kids did you adopt?
Five.
What's two more?
Oh, no, Michael. My heart can't take it. I was bitching at Jason today. Jason called me to work on stuff, and here I went on a bitch fest for 20 minutes. He goes, Jason asked me the wrong thing when he called, though. He goes, how are things? And I pulled out my damn list, and I started at the top, worked my way down.
Yeah, but, like, you know, my wife and I, we're up and for fostering again, so, you know, we're going to be doing the emergency ones for babies and smaller ones, you know.
Well, good. I'll send these up. They're still UPSable.
Yeah, we got the room, and, you know.
I'll put extra large diapers on them and send them through UPS Priority or USPS Priority. Save me some money. Holy moly. Yeah. Well, y'all, I've enjoyed. Go ahead, Mike.
There's one thing I'm going to say, and hopefully people will understand this. And I think you've said it about 50,000 times since we started these shows. This is a business, and if you don't treat it like a business, it's not going to work, period. And if you don't do the homework before you spend the money, you're not going to make it, plain and simple. You can call it what you want. If you don't make a plan and do it and check out everything, including the health department, the city, the county, it's a business, and that's the way it's got to be treated. It's fun, but it's still a business.
And that.
Here's a question here for you, Michael. Steve Spaler, he says, I'm looking at an office park / storage place in McDonough, Georgia. Has a small kitchen like an office would have. Does Michael think that might make a decent base operation? It would have a connected storage area for the car, maybe a few freezer fridges. You know, that's a possibility. I'm not sure if he's talking about just using that as a commissary for base operation, or if he's talking about, you know, like a stick and brick in an office building. If you're going to be in the office building serving them, I'd make sure you're getting some kind of compensation for it. You know, anything like that that I've looked at, you don't make enough, so then they have to pay you or money off rent or both, something like that to subsidize you to make it work. Also, whether it will work is up to your health department. You know, has a small kitchen. Is it a commercial kitchen or is it a kitchenette? Kitchenette's probably not going to be approved, you know, without your three bay, your hand, hot sink, that kind of stuff. So, Steve, there's, you know, some stuff you're going to have to do on your end, check with the health department. But, you know, could be a base operation. You know, and then again, the office park, you know, how big is the office park? Can you vend out in the office park during the week to the other businesses? So, you know, a few things to think about there.
Yeah, how many people are coming in the office park? If you can park your cart there, would the health department approve it? I mean, there's 1,000 questions. You know, the biggest thing that people forget is health inspectors can talk. They will actually sit down and tell you what you need to know. But you need to know what they know before you go in there. That way you know they're not just telling you a lie. And you do that by downloading the health inspection rules. You know, you can go online and download the Georgia code, and it don't cost anything. And if you don't want to do that, you can go to your health department, walk in and say, I need a copy of the code. And guess what? They'll print it out for you.
My favorite.
I know they will.
My favorite. Yeah, they have to. My favorite way to do it, Michael, though, instead of trying to, you know, discern the legalese that is the codes, is if I hear something that sounds hokey, like, oh, you need a pink umbrella, and that's the only color umbrellas we will accept, and you're your cart has to have 19 wheels on it, including a spare. Then you just say, hey, can you show me that in the code, where I can find that in the code? And I mean, you got to remember they work for us. I have a whole article that, probably one of the most read articles on my blog called learnhotdogs.com/liar. And it's called If Their Lips Are Moving, They're Lying. And I was being kind of facetious there because oftentimes they're not lying intentionally. They just think they've heard something and they've repeated it or they've added to it. And they out of pure ignorance, willful ignorance, because it is willful, if they have a job to disseminate information and they've chosen to disseminate wrong information, even though they have a copy of everything they're supposed to know, then there's a problem. But they're human beings just like us. You have to keep that in mind. I always like to call them out. I helped a lady recently that paid for a consultation with me, and I called her health inspector and said, listen, I'm working with Linda, and Linda says that you told her about something another on the cart. She talked about a 50-gallon water tank on the cart. Okay, 50-gallon. Okay, that's 350 pounds of water. With a reserve of
70, bigger for your waste tank.
A waste tank 75 gallon. And I said, can I see that in the code? And she goes, well, you can look that up online. I said, well, I think that you work for the state. Can you give me exactly where I can find it in the code and the exact link where I can get it? And she goes, she got snippy with me. She goes, hold on. And I said, listen, if it's too much trouble, if you'll let me talk to your boss, maybe your boss has more time. And the lady goes, no, I'll get it. And she came back. She still was snippy, but she gave me the exact link. She actually texted it to my phone. It wasn't there. It applied only to a food truck that had two axles.
Yep.
So it,
remember the one that told the guy he needed to be an NSF certified cart?
Yeah.
Yeah. Such animal. Can't do it. If it has a VIN and a tag, it can't be NSF.
Right. Yeah, that's it. That's in NSF's own codes. It's at the top. It's the first paragraph in NSF code. So
they told that guy they wouldn't license his car because it wasn't an NSF approved car. It can be built to NSF standards. It cannot be NSF certified.
Right. So I, even though NSF will take the money of some manufacturers, like I know I have a friend that manufactures carts, Dreammaker Carts. He's got a couple carts that are NSF certified, or maybe all of his carts have a variation that's certified NSF. Well, those are NSF, means they meet the standards. They're not really an NSF cart because NSF cannot approve a cart that is towed on state, city, county roads. So it's kind of just BS. It's just the way they took money from my buddy at Dreammaker, Mark. Anyway, it's after 10. We're going to close up shop. Any last words from anybody?
One thing. Sorry, go ahead.
How are we going to have them get in touch with us?
If you are interested in the thing Jason talked about and private licensing and getting the help from Jason and I, this is bigger than big. This is bigger than you can imagine. This is like a guaranteed path to your success. If you're interested in that, email ben@vendorsunited.com. ben@vendorsunited.com. And Jason or I will get in touch with you with a questionnaire. We've got an application. We can only take a certain number of these. So we're being a little picky with it because we kind of are anal about success stories. So we only want serious people so that we get only success stories. No failures. No late.
Oh, we've had some failures that we've had to help through.
Right, we have. But I don't want to blatantly take on someone who just wants to sit on the couch and somebody sent them checks like our magic button that we did.
You mean like an asshole, the ones that love to ask all the questions and then never follow through with any of the answers?
Right.
Assholes.
I like that. I like that. We need to title this show Ask Holes. All right, Matt, give us yeah. Closing words.
Well, there's one thing I wanted to do real quick, and everyone here probably uses Square or has used Square. Mm-hmm. There's a new program Square is offering, which is a loyalty program. Now it is $25 a month, but you can sign up both cash customers and credit card customers. and you do it by their phone number. Like I said, it is $25 a month, but other than that, it keeps track of everything. They earn points per their purchases, so you can set it up by percentage. Let me see if I can screen share it here.
Those percentages, dollar amount, and you do the rewards you want to put into it and all that kind of stuff. It's a good program.
I mean, it's just I've seen a couple of people ask about loyalty programs. For $25, it's a pretty good one, and you probably already use it. And you get their phone numbers. You get their, it's customizable. It's there. It's a huge company backing it, of course, with Square.
Will you be able to text them later with a special?
Yes. That's the best part of it. I was going to get to. You now have their phone number. You can text specials. You can text your menus. So that is, and I don't have anything to do with Square. So that I think the value is there, especially if you have a, if you're already vending and you have a regular basis of customers. I'd highly recommend that just because you're already probably using Square, because unless your average transaction's over, $25, you're probably not going to get a better rate. I mean, there is, some people have, disagreements with Square, but it's just something that just kind of started a little while ago.
We've tested a bunch of them, Pay Anywhere, Revel.
We tested PayPal's. We tested, who is it? AT&T's or whatever.
There are so many of them. I still wind up going back to Square every time. Most other systems are based for stick and brick, and Square has finally stepped up their game. I mean, I do my prepaid cards through them and gift cards through them, and have them printed up. And
yeah, I mean, they went public probably about 7 months ago, and I got an offer to do the IPO, and I wish I had done it. Because they've rolled out so many great programs in the last 6 months.
They offer a financing thing. I mean, if you're capital. Using it on a regular basis, I mean, I'm upwards of like $20,000 I can get for them. And
it's capital. It is a high percentage interest rate. I wouldn't recommend doing it unless you have like a big event or something like that. But if you pay it back.
It was slower when they first brought it out. It was about 13%, 10 to 13, depending on your volume. And they've also shortened the timeline on. Now it's under 18 months.
But I mean, there's that. They've got like you said, gift cards now, invoices. You can invoice if you that's not something we do a lot, but it could be for catering, invoicing, time cards, payroll. If you're not utilizing everything on Square, I'd highly recommend going and looking at everything they can do. If you have employees, you can do your payroll through them. You can do your time cards, clock in and out through Square now.
You can also through Square just get the very basic, just to be able to accept the credit card, and all it costs you is the 2.75% on each transaction. And they're real good about paying the money the next day.
Yeah.
Within 2 days.
Well, you can pay an extra 1% and get it instantly if you like. And you're talking, that is the lowest. Everything I've looked, unless your average transaction is above $25 to $50, which most of us will never reach. I would love for my average transaction to be $25. But it's just the cheapest to go. But I would just recommend looking at the other products, and especially that loyalty program, because like I said, I've got nothing affiliated with it. But for $25 a month, there's a lot of value there. It's a lot better than spending money on Facebook ads. Like, I would never spend money on Facebook anymore personally, unless you're as big as Ben or something like that. Where you're actually going to reach a large scale audience and such like that. For $25 a month, that is a huge bang for your buck. So, and then it's 2017, guys. Get it done. If this is the year, make it the year. I made 2016 the year. In 2015, I started in August, and I said, 2016, by the spring, I will be full-time. And we wrapped up our first year basically full-time and starting our second year full-time.
Congratulations, Matt.
Thank you. And it's been wonderful. And that's, just being home with the kids and everything. Guys, I always get emotional when I talk about that. But that was what it was for me. People talk about money. That was not my motivation at all.
Well, after working 90 hours a week and not seeing your kids and having to travel from state to state in your position with Cracker Barrel, I can imagine the value that it would be to be home. You know, I watched that thing when you went to the corn maze. I think it was, no, the blueberry patch.
Blueberry patch, yeah, blackberry patch.
Yeah, whatever, blackberry. Yeah. And I went, I could feel your emotion there, the fact that you got to do that. Where before it was, oh, daddy's gone, daddy's gone, daddy's gone. Your kids, you don't even get to see them grow up.
Now I get to take them to work with me.
There you go.
Now, and that's awesome. I mean, that's what it is to me. So whatever your reasoning on it, by it, if you have the dedication, if you have the commitment, you can make it happen. It's really just about, like Michael said, it's hard work. Don't expect to just, you know, get a check sent. You're going to have to go out there. You're going to have to go out and do a situation, speak to people. You know, if you're not blowing through 30, 40 business cards a week, you're probably doing something wrong. Minimum, you know, I'm just be honest. So right now, if in 2016, you didn't go through that many business cards a week, then that's your problem. Right there. You're not talking to enough people.
Yep.
Period. If you want to start catering, you got to go talk to people more than ever. That's you're going to talk to 50 people and get 4. I mean, but then guess what? Those 4 will recommend you to another 8.
And
that's how it works. It
puts you in front of hundreds
who end up, and that's what I'm saying.
Those
you get clients. You know, you get X, that's how it starts, is word of mouth. But to get that word of mouth initially, you're going to have to go out there and talk to anyone that'll listen.
Mm-hmm.
You know, start with doctor's offices. They get drug reps every day feeding them.
Yep. Yeah.
Give them a card. Say, hey, tell the drug rep you want us to come feed you.
Yep.
There was that site we talked about, Ben. It does the drug reps. You get signed up for.
I know what you're talking about. And
so tired, I can't think about it, but it's a service that's nationwide that hooks you up with the drug reps. And then for the life thing, I can't think of it.
Yeah,
I mean, the doctor's office tells them what they want half the time.
Yeah.
To be honest, I mean, they, you know, the front desk clerk, the office manager is who you need to speak to, because they're the ones that tell them, yeah, we want tacos today, you know.
Yeah, and the drug rep brings it in. Drug reps, yeah, that tells you how screwed up our system is. That it works that way, but I used to work.
But you, yeah, it's screwed up, but use it to your benefit.
Oh, right. You know? Yeah. There's nothing. And I'm not talking about changing the system, but my point is that it is a screwed up system, but you hit on a great point, because drug reps do, they bring in pens and pads and now they bring in big gifts, you know, new leather binders and new stuff. And they give it to all the employees and then they provide them lunch. And these doctors' offices are getting hit up daily from drug reps. Daily. I've got 2 family members that are doctors, and it's a daily thing.
You have to make an appointment to get into most of them.
Yeah. But they're getting bombarded. They're getting so much freebies. But it's a great idea. I know Jason brought this up before. There's a company, I don't know what it's called, I can't even remember right now.
For life, I can't think of the name of the company. We talked about it on one of the shows. Get about the site.
No, but all that keeps coming to mind is Thumbtack, but it wasn't Thumbtack.
Thumbtack. I'll tell you what, I'm getting killed on Thumbtack. I just had to put my email on hold with them because it was just literally on the average day on Thumbtack, 50, 60 emails.
Holy cow.
Now, out of that 50, 60, it might only be 20, 30 that really truly would fall into my area, but
I just found my dog trainer on Thumbtack.
So. Yeah, Thumbtack's awesome for if you're looking for extra business on your catering, you want to get your catering out. And
the one thing I can say about that though is you have to follow through and get all the things done that they want done.
Yeah,
or you don't get the work. If you get their gold standard or whatever it is, get all your stuff verified and all that, it makes a huge difference.
I still think though that what Matt's talking about, going door to door, talking to people, handing out cards, it had immediate results for Matt.
Oh, yeah.
Matt's covered up with business, and that's the way to do it, is that one-on-one, walk in the door, how you doing, here's my card, here's what we do, if you're ever having a business party, We do everything. I can bring you soup. I can bring you bow tie pasta.
Yeah, employee appreciation. Employee appreciation. That's the best thing, too. Go in, hey, talk to the manager. How many employees you got? You got 20 employees? Buddy, I can hook you up $200. I can be here at 2 o'clock. Do it after your lunch. It can be a secondary gig on that day and be an extra $200.
Mark.
That you serve 20 people. You're done in 45 minutes.
Yep. And he all he's invested is $10 an employee, but he got the value added from appreciating his employees. So,
oh yeah, come out there, do a big thing, you know, put music on, bring the cart. I mean, that's what I do. Do the bow tie and, you know, the cart and everything. 45 minutes, the employees feel like $1 million. I mean, $200 to make your employees happy is nothing.
No.
I mean, literally, we've spent at my previous restaurants, we've spent hundreds and thousands of dollars doing employee parties for hundreds of employees. It's nothing. $200, you know, but to you, that's an extra $200 a week times, you know, a month, an extra $800 a month times 12 months. You know, that's right. Just one thing a week. Hotels, doctor's offices, party cities, anything, you know, anything they got 10, 15, 20 employees, book it at 2 or 3 in the afternoon. So you get that transitional and you don't have to miss your lunch. So you get an extra gig on top of it. And it's, 45 minutes, literally. I mean, we're not talking about, oh yeah, you're going out and doing a $700 day, but $150-$200 for 45 minutes of work. Doctors don't make that. They don't make $100. I mean, that's, you're talking $100 an hour profit.
Yeah.
That's
fantastic. Matt, I appreciate you bringing up the square too. That was a good one. We haven't talked about them in a while, and that was a good point you made. And I like the new stuff. I didn't even know that. Jason, you got any last words?
No, just, the difference between, these wannabes and an entrepreneur. The entrepreneur changes. I wish to start a hot dog cart to I will, or I will start a food truck, you know, make the change at 17, make it happen. You know, you're in control, but you got to do it. There's plenty of free articles here. You know, now there's licensing and branding opportunities and things. I mean, you know, you can't say the information's not available
right.
For the help. You know. So.
Well, y'all have a freaking awesome week, month, and. And we'll see you next. Well, I'll see you on the Facebooks live, but we'll also be back February, the first Sunday of February.
That's the Super Bowl. You want?
Is it?
Yeah. We did that. That was the first time I appeared on the show was last year on the Super Bowl.
Super Bowl. It's my luck. We may change it. I may need to change it, but we're fixing to do some major changes with the show anyway. Not like the platform, but the way it's done. So it's going to be better, gooder, better, more better.
And Corey said he's sorry he couldn't make it and we're to divide his check up amongst us.
I was about to say, we still get our checks, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. That's what I would.
We just get Corey's check too. So
yeah.
So that's 0 divided by 4.
I wonder how many people really think we get checks. For
that. Where are you going to spend it?
Yeah, exactly. At the nothing.
Dude, people don't understand. Everybody's like, oh, what'd you do for New Year's? I'm like, dude, I was in bed by 10.
Oh, me too. Me too.
Yep. Me too.
What I do for New Year's. Man, I had to be at the ski resort this morning. Are you shitting me?
Well, y'all have a good one. I
have a good one.
Right, enjoyed it.
I'll take care.
It's Sunday night at 8:30, and you're riding a gravy train with biscuit wheels with a hot dog answer man, Ben, on HDVR, Hot Dog Vendor Radio.
Got a question about hot, steamy buns? Call Ben at 424-258-9364 for the latest tips and tricks in the world of wieners. That's 424-258-9364. Press 1 to talk live, one-on-one to Ben. Sunday night, 8:30 Eastern Standard Time. HDVR, hot, steamy buns.
Feeling lazy?
lazy? Out of shape? Get off the f***ing couch. Go to benscarts.com and get the scoop on free training, top-notch accessories, link over to the radio show, and the blog. Plus, you can get Ben's tell-all book on how you can change your life forever.
Hot dog, save my life.
It's all available at benscarts.com.
Be there.
He's busier than a one-armed monkey with two peckers. It's Ben on HDVR, Hot Dog Vendor Radio. Hot Dog Vendor Radio was brought to you by BensCarts.com and the hot dog answer man himself, Mr. Ben Wilson. Also by the letter H and the number one. Tune in next week for the very best hot dog vendor information money can't buy on HDVR, Hot Dog Vendor Radio.